watching WFTDA.tv.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're in the testing lab today, testing helmets to see if they pass the multiple impact certification test. We're going to be testing three helmets today. A soft foam helmet with EVA foam and a terry cloth liner. The hockey helmet with triple density EVA foam. The S1 Lifer helmet with EPS fusion foam. All three of these helmets are marketed as multiple impact helmets. We're going to test all of them today and see which ones actually pass the test. The multiple impact test is when we drop a helmet to achieve a velocity of 4.57 meters per second. This simulates a 10 mile an hour impact or a 4 foot drop. The same helmet is tested three times in the same location. The helmet must reduce the energy pulse to under 300 G's each time. Anything over 300 G's can result in a traumatic brain injury or a severe concussion. In summary, the soft foam helmet with EVA foam and the hockey helmet with triple density foam did not pass the multiple impact test. The S1 Lifer helmet with EPS fusion foam did pass the multiple impact test.
My name is Lacey Knight, and I skate with the Angel City Derby Girls. I've been evolving more and more into just having things that I know are going to be reliable, that they're going to last, and that they're going to do exactly what I want them to do. When you've reached a certain place in your derby career, it becomes less about how much you're spending on the equipment as it is about what it's going to do for you. I need to be able to have it conform to my foot so that it's just an extension of who I am as opposed to this thing that is now on my foot. The right L boot that I have now has been able to successfully do everything I need it to do. This year has even gotten better for me, and my skating is the best it's ever been, and it's the best boot that I've ever had.
They say we don't do enough. We don't stock enough skates, especially the bargain basement variety. We don't carry in lines or know the best place to get them. We don't have every package from every manufacturer. They say all these things. Yet every day, we measure your feet. We study your stance and tailor your fit. We mount your plates and answer your questions. We build skates that make you fly. We're not here for them. We're here for you. And we want to make you go really, really fast. Make them catch up. Visit us online at fastgirlskates.com.
Hey folks, welcome back. John Maddening with Bam Bam for this. The ultimate, the final game of the 2014 International WFTDA Flat Track Roller Derby Championships from here in beautiful Nashville, Tennessee.
It absolutely is beautiful. We've had a great time here in the surrounding community, and of course, the beautiful arena here in Nashville is perfect, really, for roller derby.
And once again, a big, big thanks to the Nashville Roller Girls who helped host this. There's one right there. There's a fine group of folks
everywhere,
all around here. Everywhere you see,
us.
They're surrounding us and just showering everyone here with love. Not just the volunteers, but the skaters and the officials and just everyone that's been working towards making this tournament go. So it's a big, big thanks to everyone in Nashville for helping out.
They've definitely been facilitating us to this final point. And it's a game that a lot of people thought would be coming. You've got Gotham, undefeated now for several years, up against the Wheels of Justice.
They're superheroes. They are superheroes. Will this be their final issue, or will they be reborn? All right, no. This is going to be it. This is for all the marbles, and I checked after everybody left last night. 183 marbles fit in the Hydra.
You did count them all.
Very important. So we got Rose. Rose, we were talking earlier, Rose is one of these teams that uses the width and breadth of their charter to bring the exact right players to whoever their opponent is. They utilize their charter, and they might play take out one of their best players. It's like, well, maybe one of these players is actually going to help more in this particular game. So you, when you bring the whole charter to a town, to a tournament, you have so much more to choose from, so much more that you can mold your team into.
Well, and I think, again, we've been talking about the physics of the game. When we talk about the action, equal and opposite reaction, I think you've got Gotham coming in, playing their game, and that's what they do. But you have the Wheels of Justice, who can adjust so quickly. Rose City can take what they've got, make maneuvers, make that adjustment. And when you look at the overall game, strong defense both teams, strong offense both teams. And I think that's going to be my defining factor, is that does Gotham continue on their momentum and just play their game, or are the Wheels of Justice able to adjust, make those changes, make those movements, and make Gotham then they have to change. Whereas Rose City, I think, a little bit stronger when they are that malleability. They can handle that better. They can contain themselves better.
Well, a year ago in Milwaukee, we saw these chinks in the armor of Gotham when Bay Area and then Texas took them on and really brought it down to the final minutes of each game and came closer than anyone ever had before to taking them out. But it's a year later, and Gotham is still on top. Gotham is still undefeated for, oh boy, 60-some games? 59 games?
You know, we don't need to count. There's
N,
a lot.
N plus one games for all the math nerds out there. But yeah. I think the one thing about Gotham, why does Gotham win? Gotham wins not only because they have great talent. Of course, that's an afterthought. Gotham wins because they continue to play offense and defense at the same time. So many teams concentrate on one or the other to their detriment, but Gotham is smart. Gotham has figured it out that roller derby, as we say in these Derby 101 displays, that whenever we do a little rinky-dink league in a small town in Podunk Town, we have to explain roller derby, and it's a game of offense and defense at the same time. At the top of the game, Gotham has figured this out. Not a lot of teams are following them right now, but we saw them play some very, very tough games. A very, very tough Texas team yesterday, they knocked down, and then London after that. But man, Rose City is looking so good this year.
Well, and again, I think it comes back to that simple point like you're talking about. Are you able to hold shape? Are you able to hold that rigidity and their strength in that? But much like a river can flow around and engulf something, I think that's what we're going to be looking for, to see if Rose City can take on the shape and morph over. And we're going to have that coming to you in just a few moments. We're going to take it back up to the dais.
That's right. Tara Armov and Mike Checks are going to bring you through the next about hour and a half of fun and roller derby frivolity.
It is fun.
And then stay with us. The action doesn't stop, because the most action-packed event, the medal ceremony, the awards ceremony, we're going to be giving out not only the D1 awards, including the Hydra, but also the Division 2 awards and the most valuable player of the tournament.
Indeed.
So stick with us all night here on WFTDA.tv, and we'll see you right after the game.
Well, good day to you, Derby fans and addicts. I am Mike Checks alongside Tara Armov once again. And just in case you've forgotten, you are watching the International 2014 WFTDA Championships live from Nashville, Tennessee, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Nashville Roller Girls.
I like the idea, like we've forgotten what we're doing here. What are we doing in Nashville again? Oh, yeah, roller derby.
That's
all
right.
Of the roller derby. And this is the third day. All of the games have been so much fun to watch. And this one, so many people are looking forward to seeing Rose City and Gotham. And it looks like we're going to throw on over to the house mic for introductions.
Introducing first, the challengers. number 280, Alicia Nisbett Smith. Number 127, Jessica Chestnut. Number 1719, Scylla Devourer. Number 1889, Jessica Shipley. Number 21, Kate Thomason. Number 26, Sarah Gaither. Number 307, Shayna Sarolson. Number 365, Copernicus. Number 4, Jess Rivas. Number 415, Hannah Jennings. Number 50, Skull Eagle. Number 523, Liquor and Split. Number 77, Lauren Much. And your captain, number 100, Mercy Shama. Joined by coaches Mike Wade and Coach Halslinger, ranked number 2 in the world, the Wheels of Justice.
Derby fans and addicts, those were the house introductions brought to you by our colleagues Vincent Hannity and KC Bomber.
And I am so thankful for those awesome intros because it's really getting the crowd pumped up. Not like they need a lot of reason to be pumped up, because people are really, 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 really excited to see this game. And everyone is already on the track, lined up on the Fast Girls Skate Jammer line. Oh, we have refs.
We do. We have your head ref. Umpire strikes back. The inside pack ref is Tripp and Dale. Your jam refs, Code Adam and DJ Jazzy ref. The outside pack refs, John Dilks, Izzy Demented, Patricide, and your alternate, Rock. Tara, this building is electric right now. This crowd is on fire.
It really is. I think this is the most exciting game that Gotham is playing this weekend after Texas and Gotham yesterday. And what is it, 58 games in a row, the winning streak of the girls from New York. Number 77, Lauren Much for Wheels of Justice going against number 340, Bonnie Thunders.
Pack constricted between the fast girl skate start line and the pivot line. Of course, we have a scrum start to begin. Bonnie Thunders making a little bit of headway as the pack starts to enter turn one, trying to work against the inside of Rose City's defense. Lauren Much being held in the backfield, getting a little bit of offensive help there from Jessica Chestnut. Sexy Slady moving Lauren Much to the inside. She's going to have to reset behind OMG WTF. Bonnie Thunders, one to beat up front. She is clear of the pack. First lead jammer goes to Gotham.
Last line of defense for Rose in the front there, Hannah Jennings. Trying to hold back Bonnie as much as he can. Bonnie already on her scoring pass.
Lauren Much going to the outside through turn two, as we saw her do earlier this tournament. She clears the pack, but 3 points picked up for Gotham.
Bonnie taking a little stumble there, coming out of turn two, calling out, not even looking around to see where Much is. Just want to make sure that she calls it off before Rose scores any of the points.
Our second jammer matchup will feature number 50, Scald Eagle, lining up opposite number 55, Susie Hot Rod, for Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
They're about 5 feet off of the fast girl skates jammer line. Back wall of Gotham. Scald Eagle trying to push her way through on the inside.
Susie Hot Rod trying to push out Copernicus there on the outside of the front straightaway. Scald Eagle now goes to the outside. She is clear of the pack. Lead jammer for Rose City.
It was like she was invisible. Just taking that outside line, no one even looked at her as she just strode out of there, and she is on her scoring pass.
Scald Eagle clears the pack, 5 points for Wheels of Justice. Susie Hot Rod now clears the pack, exiting turn four. Scylla Devourer moving Mick Swagger to the inside. Scald Eagle back around, clear lane to go. She is through, calls off the jam. 4 more points for Rose City.
And we already have our first lead change. Rose City at 9, Gotham 3, 27 minutes, 45 seconds in the first half. WFTDA wants to say thank you to S1 Helmets. Check out original roller derby content from S1 Helmets at www.youtube.com/S1Roller Derby and online S1Helmets.com.
Bonnie Thunders out to take her second jam for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Liquor and Split lined up to jam for Rose City. Last second adjustment by Liquor and Split, moving from the middle to the outside. She gets moved to the outside by Sexy Slady. Both jammers still in the midst of the pack. Liquor and Split with a huge lane on the inside, though, takes advantage. Lead jammer goes to Rose City. Bonnie Thunders now out of the pack, giving up about a third of the track to Liquor and Split.
Rose City building that back wall at the start there, and it was enough to stop Bonnie Thunders, just enough for Liquor and Split to get through, get 1 point, and call it off for Rose.
Jess Rivas now taking a seat in the notorious RED penalty box for Rose City. They will start down a blocker, and you see Liquor and Split there going to the outside, calling off the jam, but she was able to pick up that 1 point. We now find Lauren Much on the jam line for Rose City, opposite Vicious Van Gogh for Gotham.
Little last minute switching around. So 30 seconds are up. Lauren Much hits that back Gotham wall.
Lauren Much trying to push to the outside, now moving back to the in.
Vicious Van Gogh has two to beat in the front to make it out.
Sarah Gaither up to bridge for Rose City. Vicious Van Gogh having a hard time with Mercy at the front of the pack. Looks like Mercy has been whistled for a penalty, and now we've got Vicious Van Gogh, your lead jammer for Gotham.
Lauren Much still working on her initial pass, trying to push her way on the outside. Van Gogh is on her scoring pass.
Rose City down two blockers, having a hard time containing right now as Vicious Van Gogh clears the pack for five.
That puts Gotham at 2 points at tying Rose City.
Jess Rivas out of the penalty box for Rose City, back on the track. A penalty down in turn two. Vicious Van Gogh through the pack, 5 points for Gotham as Violet Knockout reporting to the notorious RED penalty box for Gotham.
This is already her second trip to the notorious RED penalty box.
Exit hit on Vicious Van Gogh by Jess Rivas. Lauren Much now clear the pack on her initial pass for Rose City. Mercy out of the penalty box.
And we have yet another lead change. Gotham takes the lead with 18 to Rose City's 10, 25 minutes, 8 seconds in the first half. WFTDA would like to say thank you to Bont FXX Wheels, the hottest wheels on the market, Quadstar certified, cutting edge technology. Check them out online at bont.com.
Gotham Girls Roller Derby skating in their black uniforms with white trim. Wheels of Justice skating in their white uniforms with purple trim. Scald Eagle jamming for Rose City opposite Susie Hot Rod for Gotham. Scald Eagle getting knocked down. Susie Hot Rod out front. She's battling against Jennings, and Susie Hot Rod out and declared lead jammer for Scald Eagle. A little defensive hit there against her. Takes a spill in turn four.
Rose City trying to speed up the pack as much as possible and get to the front of the pack to prevent Hot Rod from scoring easily. Hot Rod taking that inside line, little hop, picking up 2 points for Gotham. No points for Rose. Gotham at 20, Rose City 10. And here we see on the instant replay, Scald Eagle's defensive hit on that initial pass out of the pack. And down she goes momentarily.
Gotham Girls Roller Derby with the bench closest to the jam line. Wheels of Justice with the bench closest to the pivot line in this first half. Both teams going to start this next jam at full strength. Liquor and Split opposite Bonnie Thunders. Thunders to the outside, now back to the middle. Finds some room to work on the inside as Jessica Shipley goes down. She recovers, but Bonnie Thunders through the pack. Lead jammer going to Gotham Girls Roller Derby. However, behind her quickly, Liquor and Split.
Both teams, like you said, at full strength. Both teams also have 2 trips to the penalty box each.
Pack at a blistering speed right now. Bonnie Thunders catching up to the back of the pack, going out of turn two. Picks up 1 point, calls off the jam, and a track cut penalty being whistled. That appears to be going against number 503, Mick Swagger, who is now reporting to the notorious RED penalty box for Gotham.
Mick Swagger, a very effective blocker in the pack. However, it is to be noted that in the last game that she played yesterday, she did foul out against London. So it'll be interesting to see what her penalty count will be today. WFTDA wants to say thank you to Adam Wheels. Jackson, skate for the love of it. Jackson Skate. You can check them out at adamwheels.com.
Misty Maven jamming for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Lauren Much jamming for the Wheels of Justice. Misty Maven down in turn one. She's going to get recycled. Lauren and Much also being recycled back as well.
I see OMG WTF reporting to the notorious RED penalty box, as are two of Rose's blockers.
Jessica Chestnut taking a spill on the front straightaway. She was holding her mouth as she got up. Lauren Much through the pack is your lead jammer. Coming around the track quickly, goes to the outside against Sexy Slady. Calls off the jam.
Four points. I think Sadie just got an out of play penalty. I saw the referee making hand signals. Oh, maybe not.
Well, there are two blockers in the notorious RED penalty box for Gotham, so she may be forced to stay out on the track until she can serve her penalty. We see on the replay, there's Lauren Much on the front straightaway as she picked up lead jammer status for Rose City.
Beautiful work by Lauren Much on that jam. Scald Eagle back on the track for Rose City, getting hit out by Sexy Slady and picking up lead jammer for Rose.
Both teams starting with only 2 blockers on the track. Scald Eagle able to take advantage before Bonnie Thunders was able to. Thunders, though, out of the pack also on her initial pass. Sexy Slady now reporting to the penalty box, as is Mercy for Rose City.
Scald Eagle coming up behind Bonita Applebaum, passing her, calling it off as Bonnie Thunders also makes it through the pack. 4 points for Scald Eagle, none for Gotham on that pass.
And that was because Hannah Jennings was able to speed up and keep out in front of the pack there. That was an amazing foot race we just saw.
And again, this is something that we were discussing. Can Rose adjust as much as Gotham? Gotham likes to pull out the fast skating card, thinking that it's going to fool the other team. It fooled London. Texas was able to adjust to it. So far, so is Rose.
Again, each team starting with only 2 blockers on the track. This time our jammer matchup, Susie Hot Rod opposite Liquor and Split. Susie Hot Rod to the outside. She is clear of the pack, exiting turn two. Lead jammer, Gotham.
With only 2 blockers on the track, Rose just wasn't able to catch up to Hot Rod as she took that outside line on her initial pass.
Liquor and Split knocked to the outside of turn two. She is going to reset. Meanwhile, Susie Hot Rod round the pack. She is clear on a 5-point scoring pass for Gotham.
She was able to get around that partnership of Sarilson and Chestnut there at the front.
Rose City having a hard time containing Susie Hot Rod this jam. She moves to the inside through turn three. She clears turn four. And a track cut penalty on Susie Hot Rod. Power jam for Liquor and Split and Rose City.
Nice move by Liquor and Split, taking that outside line, charging that outside line. OMG WTF trying to push her. And now
there was a high block called. It overruled the track cut penalty that was originally whistled on Liquor and Split. So now we're going to find OMG WTF in the penalty box for that high block penalty.
Well, these refs are as on their game as the skaters. This is amazing. Liquor and Split, 5 points for Rose City.
Mick Swagger now reporting to the notorious RAD penalty box for Gotham. Rose City with a full contingent of blockers on the track. Gotham down to two right now as Liquor and Split round the track once more. Goes to the outside against Violet Knockout. Was escorted to the outside of turn four.
Sexy Slady coming out with her. Rose City building that back wall so Gotham can't do the soul crutch. Susie Hot Rod back on the track for Gotham.
Liquor and Split was trying to take advantage of the chaos there. She gets through the pack. Violet Knockout knocking Liquor and Split to the inside. She's going to have to reset. A multiplayer block being called. That is on Sarrelson in the front straightaway, and Susie Hot Rod through the pack on a 5-point scoring pass.
What a crazy jam. Gotham 31, Rose City 27, 18 minutes, 39 seconds in the first half of this game.
Holy cow.
I want to say thank you to Fast Girl Skates for supporting the WFTDA. Fast Girl Skates, 7 years dedicated to making a faster you. FastGirlSkates.com.
Lauren Much lined up opposite Vicious Van Gogh. Lauren Much, the tournament leader in points with 197 coming into this bout. Lauren Much quickly off the line, darting to the inside. Lead jammer going to Rose City. Vicious Van Gogh out front, gets around the front of the pack. She is clear on her initial pass for Gotham.
Nice move by Rivas at the back of the pack. She forced fisticuffs out on that inside and was able to pull her back, making it easier for Much to get through, score 4 points, and call it off. 0 points for Gotham. It is now a tied game. We see on the instant replay.
One skate.
She transitions through. Look at that. She had maybe 6 inches of space on that outside line. 31 points for each team.
Scald Eagle lined up to jam opposite Bonnie Thunders.
Waiting for the start. Scald Eagle immediately trying to shove Bonnie Thunders out of play. Unsuccessful in doing so. In fact, Violet Knockout able to shove Scald Eagle out of play, forcing her to reset behind.
Track cut penalty being called on Alicia Nisbet Smith. She will report to the notorious RAD penalty box for Rose City. Hannah Jennings, though, exit hit on Bonnie Thunders. Scald Eagle still contending with the lockdown defense at the front of the pack. Violet Knockout, Benita Applebaum, Mick Swagger, and Puss in Glutes locking it down for Gotham.
Two to beat in front for Bonnie Thunders, trying to get by Sarrelson and Jennings.
Back block penalty on Benita Applebaum. She is now going to report to the penalty box. Scald Eagle moved to the inside of the far straightaway. Bonnie Thunders is your lead jammer.
That's right. She's still working on her initial pass as Bonnie Thunders comes up and gets that jammer point. Sarrelson ready to stop Bonnie Thunders as Scald Eagle makes it out on her initial pass.
Puss and Glutes tried to put a last second hit on Scald Eagle. She absorbed it and cleared the pack. Bonnie Thunders out of the pack for Gotham. That was a 5-point scoring pass as she calls off the jam.
And again, more smart pack play by Rose City as Bonnie Thunders got out of the pack on that last pass. Rose City just slowed it to a crawl, waited for that no pack call before they sped up, and then the jam ended.
We're going to be treated to quite the chess match this afternoon.
Big thanks to Derby for All, here to help take you to the next level. Derby4all.com.
Lauren Much lined up against Misty Maven. Lauren Much so far 3-for-4 and picking up lead jammer for Rose City. Lauren Much goes to the inside on her toe stops. She clears lead jammer Rose City.
Misty Maven trying to get around Mercy there at the front of the pack and Celia Devour.
Jess Rivas to the penalty box for Rose City. Lauren Much checking in with bench coach Mike Wade, calls off the jam after picking up 4 points.
Now it is a 1-point game. Gotham 36, Rose City 35, 15 minutes, 20 seconds in the first half, and everyone is losing their dang minds.
Lauren Mutch, the full body juke as she moves into the pack there, finds room to work against Sexy Slady and OMG WTF.
A big thanks to Iron Doll Clothing. Check out our new ready-to-wear line in 10 colors and one low price, irondollclothing.com.
4-3 blocker advantage for Gotham Girls Roller Derby to start this jam. Bonnie Thunders jamming against Liquor and Split for Rose City. Liquor and Split move to the outside, going to reset at the back of the pack. Violet Knockout and Anabolics waiting for her re-entry.
Gotham has all the blockers on the track. Rose City at three, having a three wall in the front. Actually more of a braced wall triangle, if you will, if you like the geometry.
Hannah Jennings, Jessica Chestnut, and Sarilson up front on defense for Rose City. Jess Rivas now out of the penalty box. Looked like she might be playing some offense. A multiplayer block called in the backfield there. Gotham losing a blocker. Advantage Rose City.
That would be Puss and Glutes reporting to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for Gotham.
Liquor and Split trying to push against Gotham's defense in the backfield. Bonnie Thunders, you see, trying to push Rose City's defense forward.
And we've seen this a lot this weekend with many of the teams where they're deep. It's all defense all the time, and the Jammers just don't have the momentum to push themselves out of those multiplayer walls.
More than a minute has elapsed. No lead Jammer has been called. Sarilson was back to try and play a little bit of offense for Rose City.
Looks like she's going back and forth between preventing Bonnie Thunders getting out of the pack and trying to help Liquor and Split out of the pack herself. Bonnie Thunders being forced out and getting the soul crush, but now we have a back block penalty being called.
That is on Hannah Jennings.
On Hannah Jennings.
So Jammer's going to reset once again. Liquor and Split trying to make headway.
And now Violet Knockout reporting to the penalty box for Gotham.
Jessica Chestnut up trying to play offense for Liquor and Split. Liquor and Split now switching to defense in the backfield.
3-2-1. 2 minutes of just Jammer, that grind. So that it's like a meat grinder, just grinding up those Jammers and not getting them out.
And it looked like a forearm penalty was called on Rose City's Jammer Liquor and Split at the tail end of that jam. She is now reporting to the penalty box for Rose City. Wow, and the crowd's noise grew with every second that ticked off that clock that we did not have a lead Jammer, and hey, that's a surprise official timeout.
Yeah, big surprise. OTO, that's like a palindrome. And so want to thank Radar Wheels for the palindrome break. Todd erases a red dot from radarwheels.com.
So we have an official review being taken by Rose City coach Mike Wade out to the center at the conclusion of that jam.
Also, do you have feelings and opinions about this game? I bet you do out there in internet land. Oh.
Official review, White challenging the forearm call on the White Jammer.
That is a good time for an official review, I would say, in a one-point game. So again, if you have feelings about that official review, if you have feelings about this game or the meat grinder, then please go to the Twitters and go to #talk2WFTDA. The penalty count right now, Rose City with 12 penalties, Gotham at 11, with 12 minutes, 36 seconds left in this first half. And I don't know if everyone can hear at home, the crowd is dead silent right now. Everyone is taking this game so seriously. Violet Knockout is leading in penalty points. She has 4. Rivas on Rose has 4.
The forearm was called for initiating a block against an opponent with contact by the forearm. The call stands. The review is lost.
So Coach Mike Wade and the Rose City Rollers losing their official review here with 12 minutes and 36 seconds left in this first period of play. Our score remains Gotham 36, Rose City 35.
And the audience is reacting negatively to that failed official review. They have so many feelings.
Gotham fielding Susie Hot Rod at the start of a power jam.
She is set up about 7 feet behind the Fast Girl Skates Jammer start line. Rose City, they have 3 blockers on the track. They are not all together. Susie Hot Rod taking that outside line. She gets lead Jammer out of turn 1.
That was due large in part to Gotham's starting formation, which disrupted Rose City's defense to start. However, Hannah Jennings now out of the penalty box for Rose City, as is Violet Knockout for Gotham.
Hannah Jennings has had a fantastic weekend as a blocker. She is deadly effective, and especially look at this group that we have right there with Mercy and Sarah Gaither. Each team has had a power jam in this game so far, by the way.
Only 1 point separating the two teams. Susie Hot Rod finds room coming out of turn two. She is clear. That is a 5-point scoring pass for Gotham. Licker and Split trying to get around Violet Knockout at the front of the pack. Susie Hot Rod already around engaging on a scoring pass, and Licker and Split clear on her initial pass.
Sexy Slady assisting Hot Rod through that rose wall, trying to break it up. Hot Rod decides to call it off after getting 3 more points for Gotham. Gotham at 44, Rose City 35, 11 minutes, 26 seconds in the first half of this amazing game.
Lead jammers right now, Rose City 7, Gotham 6. That just helps explain exactly how close this bout is.
Big thanks to Viva Las Vegas Skate Company. They have been setting up the photo booth all weekend. We hope that you've been checking them out on all the photos online at vivalasskates.com. They have all of their photo booth photos on the WFTDA Facebook page.
Vicious Van Gogh jamming for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Clear the pack. Lead jammer going to Gotham. Scald Eagle moved to the inside by Sexy Slady. She is going to reset.
Vicious Van Gogh on her scoring pass as Scald Eagle makes it out of the pack on her initial pass.
Rivas and Sarilson at the front of the pack with Jessica Shipley. They move Vicious Van Gogh to the outside. She calls off the jam but had picked up all 5 points.
And at the very tail end of that jam, we see Bonita Applebaum reporting to the notorious RED penalty box as well. Big thank you to Roller Derby Elite. They have Roller Derby Elite Series skates involved in roller derby since 1936. RollerDerby.com.
We just saw Jess Rivas' exit hit on Vicious Van Gogh in that last jam. In this next jam, that is going to be Bonnie Thunders taking on Lauren Much.
Lauren Much going down on the inside line there, trying to take the outside, getting pushed out behind Anna Bullocks, resetting quickly.
Lauren Much trying to find work against the inside there. Bonnie Thunders being contained by Rose City in the backfield. Lauren Much trying to get around. OMG, WTF, she eventually does. Lead jammer goes to Rose City. Rose City, however, losing Copernicus to the penalty box.
They're still able to hold back Bonnie Thunders just enough. Mercy giving one last hit as Bonnie flies out of the pack on her initial pass. Much in on her scoring pass, getting pushed to the outside by number 41, Roxy Dallas.
Lauren Much, eyes locked on Coach Mike Wade on the Rose City bench, calls off the jam exactly when he asked. 4 points for her efforts.
10 points separating these two teams. Gotham at 49, Rose City 39, 9 minutes, 11 seconds in the first half of this game. About 10 feet back from the Fast Girl Skates starter line is Licker and Split for Rose City, going up against Susie Hot Rod for Gotham. Rose City setting up their wall in front, a braced wall. Gotham lined up in the back. Licker and Split looks like trying to decide on a course of action while Susie Hot Rod transitioning through on the outside.
Forearm penalty leveled against Susie Hot Rod. Power jam for Rose City. That will be their second. Licker and Split getting some offense from Jessica Chestnut up front. Licker and Split having a hard time getting around Sexy Slady. The two of them go down.
That was the most interesting fall I have seen this weekend. I hope they show that on the instant replay.
Bonita Applebaum to the notorious RED penalty box. Sexy Slady to the notorious RED penalty box. Fisty cuffs out of the penalty box, and Licker and Split through the pack. Lead jammer Rose City.
Should be noted that both jammer penalties that Gotham has committed in this game so far have been committed by Susie Hot Rod.
Licker and Split moved to the outside by Fisty Cuffs. She's going to get recycled all the way to the back of the pack. Jessica Chestnut thought she had her knocked out. Susie Hot Rod now out of the penalty box and back on the track for Gotham.
Licker and Split has two to beat in the front. Looks like she is talking to her teammates. Jennings coming up, looked like she was trying to come up for an assist, almost taking out her own team. Likkerin split through for 5 points for Rose City.
Hannah Jennings, nice moves on defense, trying to knock Susie Hot Rod out of turn four, unable to do so, tried to get her out of the front straightaway and was unsuccessful.
Likkerin split around the track, trying to take that inside, falls, decides to call it off.
Fisticuffs.
Three more points for Rose City. 2-point game. Rose City 47, Gotham 49. And here we see on the instant replay. There's that big hit by Slady.
Ooh. And that awkward fall.
Oh, I see. You can see their legs getting tangled up as they go down there. That explains a lot.
On the jam line, Bonnie Thunders for Gotham. Number 50, Scald Eagle for Rose City.
Anabolics going down in the back. Bonnie Thunders transitioning around Riva. Scald Eagle still trying to get through that back wall of Gotham. Nice transition to the outside. Scald Eagle gets out and gets lead jammer for Rose City.
Right behind her, though, Bonnie Thunders. Mick Swagger now moving up to the front of the pack, dropping Sarah Gaither on her way. Jammer's coming around. Gotham's defense in the front of the pack. Rose City pushing their blockers forward, and we're going to end with a scoreless jam there, Tara.
That was a smart move by Scald Eagle. Even though her blockers were going up for the assist as she was coming up on the pack, Bonnie Thunders was so close behind her, she didn't want to risk Thunders picking up points while Eagle was passing her own players. So the score remains 49-47 in favor of Gotham with just under 6 minutes in the first half. Want to say thank you to Something Inked, shirts, mugs, lanyards, even website design and e-commerce sites. Visit somethinginked.com.
Lauren Much jamming for Rose City. Misty Maven jamming for Gotham. Lauren Much trying to find room on the inside. Pack constricted as it just crosses the pivot line.
And again, we're seeing just braced walls galore.
Benita Applebaum being whistled for, a penalty for Gotham. She is reporting to the notorious RED penalty box. It looks like we have a direction of gameplay penalty also being called. That going against Sexy Slady. Lauren Much through the pack. Lead jammer, Rose City.
This leaves two defenders for Gotham in the pack as Lauren Much comes up on her scoring pass. She has to get through Caffeine and OMG WTF. OMG matching her move for move. Yes, there is a back block call on Lauren Much.
Crowd disagrees a little bit with that call.
I think they respectfully disagree.
Meanwhile, Misty Maven through the pack. She is clear on her initial pass. Power jam in favor of Gotham. However, they are losing OMG WTF to the penalty box now.
This is her third trip, I believe, to the penalty box.
Misty Maven staying in bounds on her toe stops. Nicely done. Oh, but a track cut penalty on Misty Maven, and we are going to do the jammer switch.
I have not seen anything like this in a long time.
I don't know that I've seen anything like this ever. So Lauren Much now out of the notorious RED penalty box. Rose City with four blockers on the track. Gotham with three. Lauren Much was our lead jammer. She is no longer. She is trying to push against the front of the pack. She gets around Benita Applebaum and clear. 5 points scoring pass Rose City, and that is a lead change.
4 minutes left in the first half of this game. Rose City 52, Gotham 49 in the middle of this jam.
Hannah Jennings to the penalty box for Rose City. Misty Maven out and back on the track for Gotham. 5 points for Gotham, four more for Rose City.
2-point game, Gotham 50. Oh no, it is a lead change. One, two, it is still a 2-point game. I can still count, I swear. Gotham 54, Rose City 56. 3 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. Hannah Jennings, four penalties in this half, matching Violet Knockout from Gotham.
Scald Eagle lined up on the jam line opposite Vicious Van Gogh. Scald Eagle trying to push forward from the center. Vicious Van Gogh working on the inside, met by Mercy Rivas and Sarah Gaither. Scald Eagle being held back by Anabolics and Fisticuffs in the backfield.
Mercy bridging and Sarah Gaither coming back to assist. And now Rivas coming back to assist.
Yeah, Rivas with nice inverse offense. Scald Eagle to the inside. She is clear on her initial pass. Hannah Jennings now out of the penalty box for Rose City. And Mercy giving chase to Vicious Van Gogh, who puts four on the board and calls off the jam.
Yet another lead change. Gotham 58, Rose City 56. 2 minutes, 37 seconds in the first half of this game. Want to say thank you to Rolline, a new generation of roller derby. Rolline, proudly made in Italy. You can check them out online at roll-line.it.
Bonnie Thunders lined up to jam opposite Liquor and Split. Bonnie Thunders moves to the outside. Zilla Devour goes down quickly back up for Rose City. Bonnie Thunders trying to push through the braced two wall at the front.
And we've seen this in this game where neither jammer being able to build up enough speed to get out. But look at that, Liquor and Split barely able to squeak by getting out and getting lead for Rose City.
The only reason she was able to do that was Benita Applebaum was down in turn two and Sexy Slady was trying to push Liquor and Split out. But Benita Applebaum actually kept Liquor and Split in bounds. Bonnie Thunders now clear of the pack on her initial pass.
Liquor and Split going down on the outside on her scoring pass. Sexy Slady falling over her as Liquor and Split calls off the jam.
Whoa, and Sarilson having some words there with Sexy Slady at the end of that jam and still having a few more words as the team's returning to the bench area. OMG, WTF, and Sarilson up in each other's face. Holy cow.
I have heard stories about teams in the middle of a game, talking to each other, having words. I have never seen anything quite that blatant in a very long time.
We've got Susie Hot Rod jamming for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Lauren Much jamming for Rose City. Lauren Much being forced out, having to reset, finds room on the inside rail. She is clear lead jammer, Rose City.
Rose City doing an excellent job of holding back Susie Hot Rod on her initial pass. Laura Much taking the outside around her own teammates, getting caught up behind Anna Bullocks and Mick Swagger.
Lauren Much twisting through the pack, one would almost say slithering the way that she is trying to work her body around Gotham's blockers at the front of the pack. Nice exit hit by Roxy Dallas is going to recycle Lauren Much. Anna Bollock's going to take her back as far as possible. Susie Hot Rod trying to work against Rivas at the front of the pack. Lauren Much finding room to work. Mercy up to play some offense, and Lauren Much clear on a scoring pass. Susie Hot Rod clear on her initial pass. Lauren Much calls off the jam. Five more points for Rose City.
And yet another lead change, by the way. Gotham at 58, Rose City 64. 2 seconds left in this period. No timeout being called.
You see on the replay there, Lauren Much with Mercy coming up and playing some offense. There she goes. Tara Armoff, I don't remember the last time I got to see a bout in which Gotham was behind going into the break. We do finally have an official review being called by Gotham's bench because we don't want to send you to halftime just yet.
How can we go to halftime? Look at this game. This is amazing.
You know, I thought the hours leading up to this bout were going to be lengthy. The 15 minutes in halftime is going to be the lengthiest halftime we've had.
We just got a great tweet on Talk to WFTDA. Lauren Bishop says, Lauren Much is why every league needs a junior team.
Truer words were never spoken. Allow me a soapbox moment for a second. If you're not checking out your league's junior derby or the junior derby happening in your area, you're missing out on some of the best derby that's being played, which is to take nothing away from the bout that we've been witnessing.
Penalties. Gotham has 22, Rose City 17. Violet Knockout for Gotham is sitting at 5 penalties. Hannah Jennings sitting at 4 going into the half. The high scorer for Rose City is Lauren Much. The high scorer for Gotham, Vicious Van Gogh.
Lauren Much 7-for-8 lead jammer status for Rose City. Vicious Van Gogh 3-for-4 lead jammer for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. What an amazing half, Tara.
And we're still in the official review. And more fun stats to talk about. I don't think I've seen this in a very long time. Rose City has gotten lead jammer 13 times to Gotham 7. That is, wow, I can't.
65% lead jammer for Rose City in the first half, 35 for Gotham. This crowd is not quiet.
Everyone's very restless right now, especially with this official review going on. And again, this is something we have not seen. We've seen official reviews going into half times or even at the end of the game. We saw that earlier today, as a matter of fact, in some of our games. but nothing at this caliber.
We are still waiting for official word from umpire Strikes Back. He is in the center with both coaches. Now the referee crew returning to the back for halftime, so I'm assuming that we are close to the end of this official review.
Both coaches for both teams out there in the infield.
Our jam timer, Nora Leaf, still signaling that it was an official timeout. She is done now, and there is our halftime signal. We are going to go into the half.
Okay, we are, yes, we're going to go into the half, and we will tell you what that official review was about when we come back.
Buy Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots.
Sometimes when you play roller derby, you're just kind of like, why am I doing this? This is so weird that I'm essentially have this unpaid second job, which I spend all my first job money to do. And then you go to, you know, you go to playoffs and you go to champs, or you just go to any game and you're like, oh, yeah, this is why I do this. My name's Steph Maney. I skate for the Linden Roller Girls, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Locker Skates, Scotland's only roller derby skate shop, situated in the heart of Glasgow. We've got your helmets, your wrist guards, your elbow pads, your knee pads, your skates, your wheels, your bearings, your places, the lot. Fifth Locker Skates. It's Dallas by the way.
In 30 seconds, I'm going to show you how to fire up your core for derby. Side lifts work your entire trunk as well as your shoulder, inner and outer thighs. Switch this to a side plank for muscle endurance and stability. I call this one a lizard plank. It's another full body exercise with a serious side crunch. Problem wrists or shoulders? Do really slow bicycles instead. If you want to hit harder and be more agile, these moves will give you the juice.
Welcome back, Derby fans and addicts. If you are just joining us, I'm really sorry.
Where have you been? Seriously, where have you been? And if you have been here, I'm sure you did not even take a break during halftime because, oh my goodness, this game is amazing.
Other than that severe case of earworm I came up with at halftime there, that was a quick halftime. Rose City 64, Gotham 58 is where we're at. Let's talk about some numbers while we've got the opportunity. In the first half, 21 jams, had a lead jammer. Rose City had 12 of those. Gotham had 9. That's 54.5% for Rose City, 40.9 for Gotham. 16 penalties for Rose City, 22 for Gotham. Of those penalties, 2 for Rose were jammer penalties, 3 for Gotham.
And with penalty points, Violet Knockout has the most penalties on Gotham with 5. And it looks like OMG has 3, so does Mick Swagger, as does Sexy Slady and Bonita Applebaum on the Gotham side. For Rose City, Hannah Jennings is the high penalty scorer, a dubious honor, with 4. And it looks like we don't even have, oh yes, Rivas has 3, and we have some people with 2 penalties. And you can look for yourself on the penalty board that is on the infield there, as umpire strikes back, conveniently stands in front of it, so you don't get the greatest view anymore.
That's all right, though. If you want to check that out online, you can actually look up the stats that were uploaded at halftime by the Ringster crew here in Nashville. Just go to ringster.net and look up one of these two teams' names. You will be able to click through and find those stats if you'd like them. Our leading scorer in the first half for Gotham Girls Roller Derby is Vicious Van Gogo with 24 points, a 75% lead jammer percentage, 3 for 4. For Rose City, Lauren Much, leading all scorers, a 30-point effort for her in the first half, also with a 75% lead jammer status. She went 6 for 8. Much followed by Liquor and Split with 21, Scald Eagle with 13, Vicious Van Gogo on Gotham's side of the ledger is followed by Susie Hot Rod with 20, Bonnie Thunders with 9, and Misty Maven with 5. Kind of surprising.
Yes, I guess it is. Hello, Quadzilla. I think this is the only time I've ever seen him without skates on, and he's not jumping over 25 people on the straightaway there. As you can see, this is a game like no other.
I was going to say, we really are seeing almost everything here.
We are seeing things we have never seen before.
Thankfully,
that is
we weren't
for sure.
Seeing everything.
And Double H wants to inform everybody, wants to remind everyone, fun is not dead in roller derby. It is alive and well, especially in this game.
The other thing that's alive and well is this crowd right now. But we promised you that we would let you know about the official review that took place at the end of the first half. Gotham was requesting a track cut penalty on Rose City's jammer. It was explained to us that no penalty was called because the skater that was theoretically cut was on their way to the penalty box, so there would have been no penalty accrued.
In other words, the no call stands.
That's right. Gotham no longer has their official review for the first half.
Seems like we are ready to go, and lined up on the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line is number 77, Lauren Much for Rose City, going up against 340 Bonnie Thunders for Gotham.
Lauren Much to the outside, almost clear. That is Fisticuffs dragging her back behind the jam line as Bonnie Thunders trying to push out Rose City's defense at the front of the pack. Rivas had dropped the bridge, as had Hannah Jennings. They were able to reform slightly as the pack constricting through the first apex, and a forearm penalty being whistled. That's going against Sarilson for Rose City, and then a multiplayer block followed. That going against Jessica Chestnut. Bonnie Thunders through lead jammer Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
Lauren Much trying to get through the four wall of Gotham in the back. Hannah Jennings was trying to assist, but now she goes up with Rivas trying to stop Bonnie Thunders. They both go down. Bonnie Thunders through for 5 points for Gotham. 1-point game right now.
Rose City trying to use the time as Bonnie Thunders coming around the track to play some offense for Lauren Mutch. Unsuccessful in doing so so far. Bonnie Thunders through the pack. 5-point scoring pass for Gotham.
Lauren Mutch getting thrown out of the straightaway on the outside there as Bonnie Thunders comes up for another scoring pass, going up against the two wall of Rose in the front. Lauren Mutch still working on her initial pass.
Hannah Jennings now whistled for a penalty for Wheels of Justice. They are getting a couple of blockers back in Sarrelson and Jessica Chestnut.
And now Bonita Applebaum going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for Gotham.
Lauren Mutch on a big spill and a great battle up front between Bonnie Thunders and Sarrelson. Bonnie Thunders, though, victorious, a 5-point scoring pass for Gotham.
We have ourselves another lead change in the process. OMG WTF throwing a big hit on Lauren Mutch. Sexy Slady doing a somersault over her as Lauren Mutch still trying to break out on her initial pass. Bonnie Thunders through for another 5-point pass for Gotham.
Lauren Mutch now moved to the outside. Jess Rivas on an exit hit. That exit hit looked like it was against fisticuffs. 4 more points picked up by Bonnie Thunders as the jam whistled to its conclusion. Gotham coming out and making a statement here at the beginning of the second half.
They definitely have things to say. I think the main thing they are saying is do not dare count us out of this game just yet.
I highly doubt anyone in this building had, but they want to make sure of that.
Big thank you to Green Monster Roller Sports. Our skates can beat up your skates with the Antic Skate Boots. GreenMonsterNoVals.com.
Scald Eagle opposite Susie Hot Rod to start this second jam of the second half. Scald Eagle goes to the outside, back to the in. She is through. Lead jammer goes to Rose City. Susie Hot Rod works on the outside, and she is clear on her initial pass for Gotham.
Very entertaining to see the Gotham blockers literally bounce off of Scald Eagle as she took that inside line to get out and get lead. Nice assist by number 26, Sarah Gaither, assisting Scald Eagle as she gets through the front, picks up her 4 points, and calls it off for Rose City.
Fans, to give you an idea how loud it is in this building right now, we cannot hear the whistles ending the jam here on the dais. The crowd is that loud. And we see there on the replay, Scald Eagle clearing right there on her initial pass.
On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have Liquor and Split for Rose City going up against Bonnie Thunders for Gotham. Line of Gotham blockers on that line preventing Liquor and Split from getting through, but Bonnie Thunders having her own troubles.
Bonnie Thunders now trying to push out Sarrelson at the front of the pack. She is working with Hannah Jennings and Rivas. Excuse me, that is Alicia Nisbet-Smith at the front of the pack. And Rivas to the penalty box for Rose City. Lead jammer goes to Bonnie Thunders.
Liquor and Split falling over her own teammate, trying to get out. Again, still on her initial pass. Bonnie Thunders hitting a 3-wall in the back of the pack.
And Liquor and Split picks up a track cut penalty power jam for Bonnie Thunders. She goes to the outside, has one left to beat. She gets around Jessica Chestnut, 5-point scoring pass for Gotham.
Rose City bleeding points right now, but they are setting up a front wall of three, waiting for Bonnie Thunders to come up again. Nice assisting by Sexy Slady as Thunders comes up on the inside.
Sexy Slady looked like she actually jumped there as she was crashing into the defensive wall of Rose City. Jess Rivas now out of the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for Rose City as Bonnie Thunders clears the pack. 5-point scoring pass, Gotham.
Thunders getting knocked around like a pinball there, but she does pick up her points for Gotham.
Liquor and Split standing in the penalty box, now exiting for Rose City. She comes in at the exit of turn four. Down the front straightaway, Bonnie Thunders pushing Rose City's defense into the turn one.
Rose City able to stop the forward momentum of Thunders just enough.
Multiplayer block being whistled against Sexy Slady. Liquor and Split trying to get around Fisticuffs and Bonita Applebaum there. Fisticuffs knocking Liquor and Split to the inside.
It looked like she was almost about to push her through on the apex. Unfortunately, Liquor and Split lost her balance, ahead went down. She finally makes it out on her initial pass for Rose City, getting one last hit by OMG WTF on her way through.
Fisticuffs to the penalty box. 4 more points picked up by Gotham Girls Roller Derby and a team timeout, Rose City.
It's team timeout. Sponsored by Adam Wheels. Train hard, play smart. Skate Adam, Adam Wheels. Gotham has broken the century mark. 101 points to Rose City's 68, 24 minutes, 23 seconds frozen on the clock for this timeout. Want to say thank you to Rollerbones. Rollerbones turbos are the wheel by which all others are measured. Check it out on the internet at rollerbones.com.
Head ref umpire strikes back, skating outside the front straightaway to talk to his outside pack refs. He returns to the center as all of the skaters are on the track, eagerly awaiting the whistle to start the next jam.
Penalty points right now. Gotham is sitting on 25, Rose City 21.
Scald Eagle lined up to jam opposite Vicious Van Gogh for Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
Rose City lined up on that back line. OMG, Bonita Applebaum turning around and staring down Scald Eagle as Scald Eagle jukes to the inside, jukes to the middle, trying to get around OMG and Bonita.
4-2 pack advantage in favor of Rose City, but Gotham picking up lead jammers. Vicious Van Gogh exits the pack. Scald Eagle working around Mick Swagger, clear on her initial pass, but giving up half a track to Gogo.
Big apex jump by Gogo. She gets through, gets 4 points for Gotham and calls it off. Gotham 105 points to Rose City 68, 23 minutes, 48 seconds. Here on the instant replay, we will see that scoring pass.
And Vicious Van Gogh had committed to that apex jump really early as you saw her swing wide through the second straightaway, landed it perfectly.
Yeah, Mercy, it would have been interesting if Mercy was standing up a little bit higher if she would have been able to catch Gogo mid-air. Back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have Lauren Much, number 77, going up against number 55, Susie Hot Rod.
Gotham really dedicating their defense to trying to contain Lauren Much. And a forearm penalty, I believe, being called against Susie Hot Rod. She'll report to the notorious RED penalty box. Lauren Much and Rose City now on a power jam.
Gotham being allowed to set up a four wall in the back, actually more of a three wall and a brace. Rose City doing an excellent job opening up that inside line just enough for Lauren Much to get through and pick up a lead jammer.
That was Sarilson crashing from the inside. And you see Rose City trying to open that entire lane for Lauren Much. She ducks to the outside around Sexy Slady, 5 points scoring past Rose City. 4-2 pack advantage affords Rose City the option of playing a lot of offense, though they are going to let Lauren Much go alone. She splits the difference, 5 points scoring past Rose City.
Susie Hot Rod coming out of the notorious RED penalty box. This has been her third jammer penalty in this game as Lauren Much picks up another 5 points for Rose City and the crowd is literally going wild.
Susie Hot Rod being contained in the pack right now. That's Jessica Chestnut and Sarilson working up front, joined by Jess Rivas.
And fisticuffs hitting out Much as she hits the back of that pack. Gotham now setting up a triangle or a brace wall, whatever you want to call it, forcing Much back 20 feet.
Look at the length of that pack. Jess Rivas exit hit on Susie Hot Rod, was unable to complete it. Susie Hot Rod clear on her initial pass. Rose City blockers back trying to play offense for Much Mayhem. Again, crash offense to the inside. Sexy Slady was waiting. 3 points picked up by Rose City as Lauren Much calls off the jam.
Gotham still at 105. Rose City now up to 86, 21 minutes, 33 seconds left in this game, and let's look at the instant replay. Nice juke and jive around OMG WTF at the front of that pack by Much, and we have another. Just excellent work. That forward momentum is what is carrying these jammers through these packs in this game.
So, Tara, we're going to start this next jam with an empty Notorious RED penalty box. Both jammers already off the Fast Girl Skate start line. Bonnie Thunder's jamming for Gotham. Liquor and Split for Rose City. Liquor and Split trying to find work through the middle. Bonnie Thunder's now pinballing her way through. Scylla Devour, last line of defense up front, but Bonnie Thunder's through. Lead jammer, Gotham.
Liquor and Split looked like she was trying to follow Mercy through. She does finally make it out on her initial pass, but Bonnie Thunder's coming up on her first scoring pass.
Liquor and Split clear on her initial pass, is caught up to the back of the pack, tried to force her way through. No points, 1 point for Gotham.
106 points for Gotham to Rose City's 86, 20 minutes, 31 seconds left in this game. Again, we want to thank Adam Wheels, adamwheels.com. Check out the Jackson Skate. Skate for the love of it.
Scald Eagle lined up to jam opposite Vicious Van Gogh. Packs still at full strength for each team.
Violet Knockout turning around. Again, that doing that stare down against Scald Eagle. Scald Eagle not being intimidated by that. She's just going to attack that wall as Vicious Van Gogh pushing out the Rose 3 wall in front.
Sarilson on offense thought she had the lane open for Scald Eagle almost, but door was shut by Gotham. Scald Eagle to the outside. Sexy Slady was waiting for, and a big hit at the exit of turn two is going to recycle Scald Eagle. Meanwhile, Vicious Van Gogh fighting against the Rose City defense up front.
Rose City staying in proximity, still preventing Gogo from getting out and getting leads so far. Look at that brace three wall in front.
And it keeps rotating for Rose City. That is Hannah Jennings that has dropped the bridge for Rose City. Are you kidding me?
Did we just see that?
We did. It was a low block call. Apparently you cannot crawl through an opposing defender's legs.
The more you know, star swoosh.
Scald Eagle tries to go around the outside, knocked out by OMG WTF. She's going to be reset. This is a power jam for Rose City. Scald Eagle trying to get through the pack. She goes down, does not try to crawl through the defender's legs. Looking to call it off, she does. Wow.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Let's see the instant replay. Again, looking at the Rose City's three wall. That brace wall and, crawling through. I haven't seen anything like that in Derby, and I haven't seen any movement like that from anyone except from children on a playground when they're about four. Pivot line start for adding, this next jam.
Adding to the list of things you don't see terribly often in roller derby.
Number 77, Lauren Much, starting out this power jam, taking the outside line, picking up lead jammer status for Rose City.
Vicious Van Gogh out of the notorious RED penalty box. Rose City blockers waiting for her at the exit to turn two. Lauren Much around the track, bounces off of Mick Swagger, falls down after taking a hit from Roxy there.
Going for the assist from her team, steps out. Benita Applebaum there to stop her, forcing her back, but she gets through. That is 5 points for Rose City. They're up to 91 to Gotham's 106 as she comes around for another scoring pass.
Violet Knockout out of the penalty box, going to be replaced by Mick Swagger for Gotham. Small pileup in turn three. Lauren Much spins around on her toe stops.
Big hit by Roxy Dallas. Lauren Much nails the landing. She stays in bounds. She picks up another 5 points for Rose City.
Vicious Van Gogh escapes the pack on her initial pass for Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
Lauren Much signaling to her team. She's saying, look, the other jammer is right behind me, taking a shirt whip, now forcing the call off. Oh my goodness. 10 points are separating these teams. Again, Gotham 106, Rose City in 96, 17 minutes, 3 seconds left in this game. And look at the instant replay.
Toe stop staying in bounds, spinning around Benita Applebaum there, shrugging off a hit, and again staying in bounds on one skate. Drops the toe stop to keep her there. Absolutely amazing. Licker and Split now jamming for Rose City. Bonnie Thunder's wearing the star for Gotham.
Rose City again building those bracing walls, unable to keep back Bonnie Thunder. She does pick up lead jammer for Gotham.
Rose City then goes on offense. Licker and Split clears the pack on her initial pass, giving up a little less than half the track to Bonnie Thunders, who's already in the back of the pack. Jukes around Jess Rivas, calls off the jam. 3 points picked up on that scoring pass for Gotham.
And again, Sexy Slady, she is really good at both defense and offense. You saw her coming up on that wall, as we can see in the instant replay there, just breaking apart Rose on that pass as Bonnie Thunders comes through and scores her points.
Nice screen offense there by Mick Swagger.
A big thank you to Rydell Skates for being a sponsor of WFTDA. The Blue Streak by Rydell. Raw power, just add skater, rydellskates.com.
Scald Eagle opposite Susie Hot Rod. There is your jammer lineup for this jam. Scald Eagle trying to find room to work on the outside. Susie Hot Rod pushing on the inside. That's Mercy and Scylla Devour trying to hold her back. Copernicus trying to play offense on the inside. Susie Hot Rod takes advantage, goes low and outside. She is clear of the pack. Lead jammer goes to Gotham.
Again, Scald Eagle looked like she was trying to take the friendly side there. She finally makes it out on her initial pass as Susie Hot Rod comes up for a scoring pass.
Susie Hot Rod getting moved to the outside. She falls down in turn two, calls off the jam. Awaiting a point tally for Gotham there. Outside pack ref talking to the jam ref. 1 point picked up by Gotham.
You see here on the instant replay is Hot Rod coming through on her initial pass.
Low and outside through turn two. That seems to make a lot of money for the jammers on both sides.
I am pleasantly surprised to see some of the similarity of skating styles that we are seeing from both teams. If anyone was wondering whether Rose was up to the challenge of playing Gotham, here is your answer, friends and neighbors.
That's right. Out in front, that is Bonnie Thunders pushing Rose City's defense forward. She has been declared lead jammer already. Lauren Much in the backfield for Rose City. Bonnie Thunders knocked down in the front straightaway. Jess Rivas and Sarrelson going right at Bonnie Thunders. Lauren Much knocked to the outside. Mick Swagger drags her back. Jess Rivas was back to play a little bit of offense.
Gotham losing a blocker to the notorious RED penalty box. Roxy Dallas taking a seat for 30 seconds.
Bonnie Thunders struggling against Rose City's defense as the pack starting to enter turn three. Lauren Much having a hard time with the Gotham defenders. Pack really constricted as it starts to enter turn three.
And again, as we are seeing over and over, the momentum being taken away by both jammers, just making it super difficult for them to get through. Nice assist by OMG for Bonnie Thunders. Not enough to get her through. Lauren Much going down on the outside. She managed to stay in bounds. At first, I thought she was being called on a penalty, but no, they let her go. Bonnie Thunders being forced to call off the jam because she just could not break through that Rose City braced wall.
That penalty that you thought you heard being leveled against her was actually a forearm penalty that went against OMG WTF. That is her fourth penalty.
Benita Applebaum is sitting at six penalties on the Gotham side. Hannah Jennings still sitting at five on the Rose side. On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have Scald Eagle versus Vicious Van Gogh. Vicious Van Gogh going up against the Rose wall in the back of the pack.
Scald Eagle started to move to the outside. Thinks better about it. Goes back to the in. Copernicus trying to help her through. Now back to defense all for Rose City. Copernicus now bridging back, trying to draw the track cut on Vicious Van Gogh. Scald Eagle trying to find work on the inside as Scylla Devour up to play offense. Scald Eagle stretches out. Gotham's defense clears the pack, exiting turn two. Lead jammer Rose City.
We see Gotham setting up a back wall as Scald Eagle comes up on her first scoring pass while Rose holding back Vicious Van Gogh at the front. But Scald Eagle getting a back block penalty. This is a power jam advantage for Gotham. Scald Eagle slowly making her way to the notorious RED penalty box as Vicious Van Gogh comes up for a scoring pass.
Full strength on both teams. Offense coming from the outside to the in for Gotham. Looks like we got a whistle penalty. That is a forearm going against Sexy Slady as Vicious Van Gogh trying to push out Mercy and Scylla Devour at the front of the pack. Scylla Devour dropping a shoulder into Vicious Van Gogh, who's now working against Copernicus.
I like the bracing that Silica was doing against Gotham there on that pass. Forced to let her go. That is five more points for Gotham. 119 points right now as Gogo comes up on another scoring pass against Rose's four wall in front.
Scald Eagle out of the penalty box, crashes into the pack. Nice cycle up by the Gotham blockers. That's Violet Knockout doing a great job. Mercy knocking out Vicious Van Gogh outside of turn four. Vicious Van Gogh slow to get up. She has recovered and is back on her skates. Scald Eagle through the pack on a four-point scoring pass for Rose City.
Now this is interesting. Vicious Van Gogh not calling it off. 5 points for Scald Eagle. Rose City breaking the century mark. 105 points to Gotham's 119. Four more points for Gotham, so it's actually 123, Rose City 105. 10 minutes, 55 seconds left in this game. I want to say thank you to Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious RED. 100% natural product for to knock out 100% of your gear stench. Order online at NotoriousRED.com.
That pass you saw by Scald Eagle there on the instant replay was her coming out of the Notorious RED penalty box and clearing on that pass. Back to the action on the track. Liquor and Split jamming for Rose City opposite Bonnie Thunders for Gotham.
Liquor and Split going down behind Mick Swagger there and having to reset behind a Gotham three wall in back. Now it's a four wall. So we have a straight across wall and a braced wall. Really nice resetting by both teams. Liquor and Split pushing the Gotham defenders out of play.
Lead jammer, Liquor and Split, as she pushes out the Gotham defense. Bonnie Thunders having trouble in the backfield. Sarrelson whistled for a penalty. She'll report to the penalty box for Rose City. Bonnie Thunders taking a beating from Jessica Chestnut at the front of the pack.
Liquor and Split going down on the outside, having to reset. Calling it off before Thunders gets a chance to score. 2 points for Rose City, 107 for Rose City, 123 for Gotham. 9 minutes, 37 seconds left in this game.
Those 2 points partially courtesy of Hannah Jennings' offense there. She has been a force both on offense and defense for Rose City. There you see Liquor and Split trying to push out the pack. This was on her initial pass. She got to take advantage of the communication problem there, it seemed, that Gotham was having, and she cleared for lead jammer status.
Lauren Mutch back on the track, making it out, getting lead jammer status for Rose City.
Susie Hot Rod fighting against Scylla DeVauer at the front of the pack. One on one they go. Lauren Mutch already lead jammer. Sexy Slady knocking her out. A low block penalty called, and Lauren Mutch calls off the jam. 4 points on that scoring pass.
Rose City 111 points, Gotham 123. And we see on the instant replay Mutch coming through, getting pushed out of bounds by Sexy Slady. That forces the call off for Rose.
And it was that leading leg hit that drew the low block penalty on Sexy Slady. She will start out blocking for Gotham as the in is full, so to speak. Two Gotham blockers in the penalty box already.
Sexy Slady and Bonita Applebaum both sitting on 6 penalties for Gotham. Hannah Jennings, she's been sitting on 5 penalties for a while for Rose. She's been skating clean so far. Hope I didn't just jinx it.
Bonnie Thunders knocked to the inside. That allows Scald Eagle to go to the outside. She has been declared lead jammer for Rose City. Bonnie Thunders still trying to work through turns 1 and 2. That is Chestnut and Sarrelson there on lockdown duty.
Scald Eagle doing what Scald Eagle does best. Jumping and hopping through. 5 more points for Rose City. Sexy Slady finally reporting to the Notorious RED penalty box.
Sarrelson headed to the penalty box. So is Jennings. One of the two of them going for a high block penalty. Bonnie Thunders now clear on her initial pass, followed through the pack by Scald Eagle on a 4-point scoring pass.
Scald Eagle calling it off. She has brought... Yeah, I'm going to be quiet for a second because, oh my gosh. 3 points are separating these two teams. Rose City 120, Gotham 123, 7 minutes, 16 seconds left in the game.
Jessica Chestnut dropping Bonnie Thunders on the instant replay, and we have an official timeout being taken on the track. So fans, let's take a moment to reset here. We've got 7 minutes and 12 seconds on the period clock. 123 points for Gotham, 120 for Rose City.
It looks like the stoppage of gameplay is because we think Sexy Slady... We're looking at penalty points. We don't know if that is what this is about.
Well, we now have fisticuffs over being looked at by the medical staff.
Looks like, yes, they're checking out her face. She may have been gotten knocked to the face. She is back up and reporting back to the bench. So now this is a team timeout, I think, which means it is sponsored by Adam Wheels. Train hard, play smart, skate Adam, Adam Wheels. Oh, it is an official timeout.
That's about how much stuff is going on this... in this bout right now. So much stuff.
So many things. It's very hard to keep track, even with so many sets of eyes on all of the action.
Official review for Gotham contesting the lack of a cutting call on the white jammer.
But we have umpire strikes back to set us straight. This is an official review, and you heard exactly why.
So everyone is going to, we see the zebra huddle in the middle, the referees discussing what they saw.
Hey, look there at the notorious R.E.D. penalty box. That is Hannah Jennings sitting alongside Sarrelson.
And we see Sexy Slady sitting on the Gotham side. Everyone looking very tense, understandably so. I think everyone is literally on the edge of their seat. Have you been talking to hashtag talk to WFTDA internet watchers? I sure hope you have. And we see Nisa Thompson saying, I just got goosebumps. Yeah, you and everybody else. Phoenix and Flame says, wow, who comes from a 30-ish point deficit against Gotham to get within 3 points? Wheels of Justice, that's who.
Dear Twitter, sorry if it's been a one-sided conversation. There's been a little stuff going on here.
You can send us photos of your animals also watching happily, avidly, as it were, to this game.
I'm going to abuse the fact that I've been given a microphone, and I'm going to say hello to the watch party that is going on back at the hangar in Portland, Oregon. Hello.
Hello.
Referees did not observe the hips drop back before re-entering. The no call stands. Official review lost.
Gotham has used their official review for this half. Interesting turn of events. Had they not had that first official review at the end of the first half, they would have lost that one. Well, they did lose it, but it was at the very, very end of the first half, so it kind of doesn't matter. So they have lost it for the second half as well. Back to the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line, we see Bonnie Thunders, number 340 for Gotham, going up against Lauren Much, number 77 for Rose City. We have a three wall of Gotham and a twofer of Rose City. Lauren Much pushing through, getting past OMG and Mick Swagger. She's pushing them out of play. They push her out of bounds.
Somehow there was still a pack there. Lauren Much recovers. Lead jammer goes to Rose City. Jess Rivas out front. Going to get some offense from Mick Swagger, it looked like. Mercy trying to hold back Bonnie Thunders. Unable to do so. She is clear on her initial pass.
Mercy and Rivas taking each other out as Lauren Much comes up on her scoring pass, picking up 3 points for Rose City, tying this game. 123 points for both teams, 6 minutes, 30 seconds left on the period clock. If we're not saying anything, it is because we're afraid to say things, because we are as wrapped up watching this game as everybody else. Three Gotham skaters have 6 penalties. That would be Benita Applebaum, Sexy Slady, and Violet Knockout.
Scald Eagle jamming for Rose City opposite Susie Hot Rod for Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Both teams choosing to go all defense at the start of this jam. Pack slowly making its way into turn one. Susie Hot Rod making a little bit of headway against Rose City's defense. Rose City losing Jessica Chestnut to the penalty box. They now at a blocker disadvantage, 4-3. Scald Eagle in the backfield trying to get around Fisty Cuffs, caffeined Mick Swagger. Susie Hot Rod having a hard time getting by Mercy. Mercy with the exit hit. Susie Hot Rod slightly recycled but finds room on the inside. Lead jammer goes to Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Scald Eagle now clear on her initial pass, giving up less than a quarter track to Susie Hot Rod.
We have Fisty Cuffs going to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Susie Hot Rod clears the pack. 4 point scoring pass, Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
Gotham breaking the tie, 127 to Rose City's 123. We see on the instant replay, she comes up for her scoring pass. We have about 5 minutes left in this game.
Gotham, great bit of distraction offense there, allowing her to get through on that 4 point scoring pass. Lauren Much opposite Bonnie Thunders, the two highest scoring jammers in this tournament coming into this bout. Lauren Much crashing into the back of the pack, tries to find room to work on the inside. Door shut by Sexy Slady. And now it's Lauren Much up front. One-on-one battle going on at the front of the pack. And Lauren Much through the pack. Lead jammer goes to Rose City.
Roxy Dallas paying the price. going to the notorious RED penalty box. Lauren Mutch coming up on her scoring pass, meeting up with OMG WTF. She picks up 5 points for Rose City. 1 point lead for Rose City.
Sexy Slady, now your jammer of record for Gotham Girls Roller Derby as the cap has been passed. Lauren Mutch knocked to the ground, calls off the jam.
Three-point
scoring pass for Rose City.
Gotham 127, Rose City 131 points, just under 4 minutes left in this game. Remember last year when Gotham played Bay Area and everyone lost their minds, and then for the championship, Gotham played Texas and everyone lost their minds? And then remember this year when Gotham is now playing Rose City and everyone is really losing their gosh darn minds? Oh my goodness.
We got a team timeout. That one being taken by Gotham Girls Roller Derby. Now they have used their official review in the second half and they have used one of their three team timeouts.
And again, the team timeouts are sponsored by Adam Wheels. Train hard, play smart, skate Adam, Adam Wheels. And thank you, Twitterverse, for sending a photo of your pets watching this game. That dog, who is that? Rachel Roman, thank you so much. On the edge of my paws. That is fantastic. Looks like the minute timeout is up. The team timeouts are 1 minute long on the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line. Number 50, Scald Eagle, going up against number 55, Susie Hot Rod.
3 minutes, 46 seconds left in this second half of play. Rose City, a 4 point advantage. Your score, 131-127. And here we go.
Scald Eagle going for the juke against that back Gotham wall. She is forced out, having to reset behind Sexy Slady.
Scald Eagle staying inbound. Sexy Slady trying to move her to the outside. Now back to the in. Susie Hot Rod fighting against the swarming wall of defense by Rose City. Scald Eagle making a little bit of headway against Gotham's defense. We've got two separate portions of the pack, 4-on-4. Scald Eagle moving to the outside, going to be reset at the entrance to turn one. Susie Hot Rod in the middle of the first apex, tries to go to the inside. Sarrelson shuts the door on her. Scald Eagle to the outside. Mick Swagger waiting for her. Sexy Slady up front. Scald Eagle
barely staying in bounds. I think she has Gorilla Glue on those toe stops as she nails it and gets lead jammer for Rose City. Susie Hot Rod also out of the pack on her initial pass. Rose City slowing down that pack as Scald Eagle comes in on her scoring pass. She goes down in the front as Susie Hot Rod also hits the back of the pack.
Forearm penalty to Roxy Dallas, who's now in the notorious RED penalty box. Scald Eagle clears on the inside rail of the front straightaway. 4 point scoring pass, Rose City. Susie Hot Rod mired at the exit of turn four by Rose City's defense. Scald Eagle all the way around the track. Knocked to the outside by OMG WTF. Scald Eagle back in around the pack. 5 points scoring pass, Rose City.
That was excellent work by Rose City's pack, opening up that inside line for Scald Eagle as she came up and then closing the door on Susie Hot Rod. Scald Eagle being forced to the infield, hopping back onto the track, but now there is a track cut being called on Scald Eagle. She is going to sit in the notorious RED penalty box. Susie Hot Rod through for 5 points for Gotham Girls.
So we will see how Rose City can kill a penalty against Susie Hot Rod now. Susie Hot Rod slowly around the track. Rose City had sped up the pace of the pack. Mick Swagger up to play some offense. Mercy shutting the door on Susie Hot Rod. Jam whistled to its conclusion. No points on that scoring pass for Gotham. 4 points were being held for Rose City's jammer, and we have an official timeout. Coach umpire, or head ref umpire, strikes back, calling the coaches to the center of the track. Official review for Rose City.
I really liked what Rose City did on that power jam. They didn't just make a static wall. They weren't going to stand still. They had their brace going all the way across the track, just started slowly moving, and Gotham went with them, which was fascinating. And then as Hot Rod came up and Gotham came in to assist, Rose City just picked up the pace and were able to make that work for Rose very, very well.
Rose City official review contesting the cutting call on the white jammer.
I don't find that at all surprising. Do you, Tara?
Nope. That is the one non-surprising thing in this game so far.
That's a true right there. Holy cow.
The clock is stopped at 1 minute 43 seconds. Rose City 144 points to Gotham's 132. And as you can see on your screen, people are a little excited for Scald Eagle right now.
If we're not careful, the building's actually going to lift off. There's so much flapping going on.
We have had our first foul out in
this
game.
Results of the review, both toe stops came back inbounds. The cut happened and stands, the loss of review.
Both teams now have lost their official review. Again, 1 minute 43 seconds left on the game clock. And, wow, so our first foul out, according to Ringster, Hannah Jennings from Rose City, she ended up with 9 penalties.
You know what, if you're going to go out, get your money's worth.
Go out big, especially if it's the championship game for the international championships of WFTDA.
Bonnie Thunder starting out in this power jam. Gotham making her go alone against Rose City's defense. Scald Eagle standing in the notorious RED penalty box. She will be released now.
Another thing I have not seen before is the blockers standing behind the jammer line at the start of that jam. Bonnie Thunder's making it through, getting lead jammer for Gotham. Scald Eagle trying to break out of that Gotham wall in the back.
Jessica Chestnut to the notorious RED penalty box for Rose City. Forearm being called against Sarrelson. They are now down 2 blockers. Scald Eagle trying to push against the defense in the backfield. Goes to her toe stops around turn 1. OMG WTF out front trying to hold back Scald Eagle. Jess Rivas up to play some offense, and nice job recontaining by Gotham. Sexy Slady dropping Scald Eagle in turn 4.
Bonnie Thunder's taking that inside, taking advantage of the penalties that Rose is committing, with Sarrelson sitting in the notorious RED penalty box. That is 5 points for Bonnie Thunders. She is closing the points gap that Gotham is holding.
Now, Gotham losing both Mick Swagger and Sexy Slady to forearm penalties, if I'm not mistaken, but I don't have time to look. I believe that's both their 7th. Bonnie Thunders through the pack, 4 points scoring past Gotham girls roller derby.
Scald Eagle getting forced out by Bonnie Thunders, just barely stopping before the track cut. She resets behind, another 4 points for Bonnie Thunders, and Gotham, we have a lead change.
Score on the board right now, Gotham 146, Rose City 144. There is differential between the jam clock and the period clock. Jam is over, team timeout being called. No, that is it.
I'm in shock. That was the craziest last jam I have seen in a long time. The unofficial final. Gotham 147, Rose City 144. I think I'm about to have a heart attack. Oh my goodness. Gotham congratulating themselves there on the track.
Keep in mind, fans, this score is unofficial right now. 147, Gotham Girls Roller Derby, Rose City 144.
Rose City huddled in front of their team bench right now. That is the final score. It is confirmed. Gotham wins first place yet again. Again, the final score, 147 to Rose City's 144. I have never seen you this speechless, Mike. Jeez.
I have never witnessed anything quite like that before. That was
that bout
had just about a little bit of everything. It had a lot of other stuff, but it had a little bit of everything. It came down to the final jam. It came down to the waning seconds. Gutsy performance by Rose City, and Gotham retains their championship yet again.
I cannot remember the last time I have seen a score this close, especially involving Gotham and especially involving a championship game like this.
Gotham down at halftime, extending their lead to about 30 points in the second half. Rose City comes back, couldn't quite pull it off.
They came close, and interesting, Gotham picking up 38 penalties in this game to Rose City's 33.
Fans in the stands standing up. A round of applause for both of these teams.
There are very many feelings going on right now in the crowd. We see the London Bridge for Gotham on their victory lap. They fought hard for this. Both teams, incredible, incredible job. Again, the styles of play very complementary to each other. The high score for Rose City, Lauren Much with 73 points. Bonnie Thunders ending up being the high score for Gotham at 60.
So for Rose City, a little bit of a silver lining. That means Lauren Much, your points total leader for the entire tournament.
Scald Eagle also getting 48 points for Rose City. Liquor and Split with 23. Susie Hot Rod picking up 25 points. Vicious Van Gogh 37 points for Gotham.
Interesting to note that Misty Maven and Susie Hot Rod both negative point differentials as jammers. Misty Maven negative 12, Susie Hot Rod negative 40. Liquor and Split a negative 14 differential for Rose City. Wow. Fans, remember, you might want to go back and watch this one in the archives.
Definitely. There is a lot to take in with this game.
I can't wait to go back and watch it in the archives.
The skills, the strategy, the use of timeouts, the use of official timeouts and official reviews, just about everything is worth watching over and over and over again.
Fans, we want to thank you very much for joining us here on WFTDA.tv. Remember, we do have the award ceremony coming up here shortly. Please to be joining us for that. You do not want to miss it. You've been watching the 2014 International Championships of the WFTDA here in Nashville, Tennessee on WFTDA.tv.
My name is Nocturne Alley. I started with a beginner set of skate. They were really not responsive. When I got my Rydells, all that was different. They contoured my feet really well. Everything that my foot wanted to do, that my brain was telling my foot to do, my skates did that for me. The idea of quality hand stitching, that's really kind of awesome. They've held up really, really well. I know I'm probably gonna need new skates eventually, but I think I'm just gonna get the same pair, honestly. Getting the skates helped me realize my potential as a skater.
We'll be right back.
Steve.